I'm L.A. Rotheraine, and this is a video about how we make our seeds for our world-famous Selke Biodynamic Cherry Tomato plant. I've been cultivating these seeds for over 25 years. Here you're going to see one of our Selke BD Cherry seedlings and what it can turn into if you build your organic hill according to our specifications and, of course, use our special seed. The ancient civilizations on the planet knew, and science has forgotten, that all plants are small models of the stars and planets. And unless this knowledge is incorporated into your seed-making technique, you're never going to produce a 12-foot by 10-foot plant like you see in this picture that can produce in excess of 2,000 tomatoes per plant. People have said that this plant looks like it comes from a world age when dinosaurs roamed the planet. And again, our secret is absorbing, calculating, and utilizing the energy from the heavens in conjunction with earthly energy. If you alter the genetic structure of the plant by altering the seed, the plant can never replicate its heavenly image. Science has approached this from a 180-degree backward view. You can't alter the genetic structure of this plant or any plant and expect an improvement.
The first thing you want to do is get a healthy tomato plant, like the one you're seeing now. Then you take a tomato. Here we're going to take a whole clump. And you only want to make your seeds from tomatoes that are ripe or overripe. Now we're going to go over and I'll show you how to slice the tomato and take the seeds out of it. Use a tomato that's orange. The tomato must be ripe or overripe. So we could use a tomato like this to make our seeds. We can't make a tomato like this to seed. First thing we do is take the tomato. You always slice it from the stem, the blossom end across, because it's easy to take the seed out of. Just make a simple slice. Now on the cherry, you want to save the meat. On all your tomatoes, you want to save as much meat as possible. So you gently pop the seed pocket out, as such. You don't have to destroy the tomato. This is our Selke BD cherry tomato, by the way. And the other hand. Okay, you see we have all our tomatoes harvested and we have all the seeds in a jar. Now twice a day, we stir about 7 times in each direction to enhance the fermentation process and clean off all the residue on the tomato seeds. But our key step here is juice of valerian flower, BD Prep 507. We always put a little bit of juice of valerian flower in the tomato seeds about to be fermented. Now I'll give you an example of what the fermentation process looks like when it's complete. The complete fermentation process, you see a mold, a fine gray white mold formed on the top. This means the seeds have been fermented and it's time to wash them and clean them off and set them out to sun dry. Most important thing in choosing a date to start your fermentation process is the stars, planets, and sun. We always like to start our special seeds when the moon is in Leo and the sun is in Leo. This particularly enhances the qualities of the seed. You just keep diluting seeds. Make sure you don't pour any of the seeds out. The ones at the top, after you let them sit for a few minutes, will be the empty husks and bad seeds. They'll be hollowed out inside, so you can pour them off. keep diluting the solution. Let the seeds float to the top and then pour them off. And now we're going to pour the seeds on a screen to sun dry. We just pour through, separate them as much as we can. We keep doing this until we have nothing but seeds on the screen. A normal house screen is sufficient. And we'll smooth them out gently so we don't crush them because they're soft. We'll get rid of the denser particles and let them sun dry for anywhere from 3 to 9 or 10 hours.
For a free pack of seeds, just send us a self-addressed stamped envelope to the address on the screen.